Oi pessoal, tudo bem? Aqui é a Luciana da Street Smart Brasil. So today you're going to learn how to use the verb ficar correctly. And I am sure your Portuguese will thank you for that. So you may be thinking, but it's so easy. Ficar means to stay. Yes, literally it does. However, we can also use ficar. In fact, we use it a lot, meaning to be or to get. Like when I say, my husband was surprised at the news, or the kitty was surprised at the sudden noise. And so this is what makes a lot of Portuguese learners confused, because they tend to use ficar when they shouldn't, and they tend to use the verb ser when they should use ficar. And with this lesson, I hope to clarify that for you. So first, let's see the conjugation of ficar. Ficar is a regular verb ending in AR, so it's easy conjugation, but there is something you need to know in order to write it correctly, to spell it right in some verb tenses. So think about the simple past of regular verbs that end in AR. So for instance, falar, eu falei. Cantar, eu cantei. Comprar, eu comprei. Now, when you follow this pattern and you conjugate ficar as a regular verb in the past tense, what do you have? Fisei. That's not right. That's right, the sound of the verb just completely changed. Ficar, fisei. This is not right. And this is because when the letter C is in front of the letter E, this is the sound it makes, like an S. So we have a trick to do this, to write ficar in the past. Instead of this, we use fiquei. We put a QU and that changes the sound to agree with the infinitive. Ficar, fiquei. Well, the other conjugations of the simple past are just regular. Você ficou, a gente ficou, nós ficamos, eles ficaram. Now, the QU situation also happens with the present subjunctive and with the imperative or the commands. I have a lesson on the commands conjugation, so I'll put that in the video description. You can also search my YouTube channel. And in these other tenses, it doesn't happen just with eu, as in the past tense, okay? It happens with all the conjugations in these tenses. So there are many places you can go and look up conjugations online. I don't want to make this lesson super long. Conjugation is really just a matter of memorizing the patterns. So I'll put a link to conjugations in the blog post. Okay, so first I'm going to give you a few examples using the verb ficar, meaning to stay, which is its literal meaning. So it's nice for you to know how to use it. Meus pais vão ficar comigo por 2 semanas. So I'm saying my parents are going to stay with me for 2 weeks. All the examples with their translations and links to additional resources are on my blog post, and I very much encourage you to visit my website and follow along with the blog post. And the link to the post is in the video description. I'll read this one once again. Meus pais vão ficar comigo por 2 semanas. Onde você vai ficar em São Paulo? Vai ficar na casa da Ana? So where are you going to stay in São Paulo? Are you going to stay at Ana's? Again, onde você vai ficar em São Paulo? Vai ficar na casa da Ana? Quero ficar em casa e descansar no fim de semana. I want to stay home and rest on the weekend. Quero ficar em casa e descansar no fim de semana. Great, now we get to the real thing here. So how to use the verb ficar, meaning to be or to get. And you know, you may be thinking, but if it's to be, why don't I just use ser? Because you can't. There are situations in which you need to use the verb ficar when in English you would say he was or she was. And I have a trick for that, okay? My trick is that when you use ficar in these situations, you're using it with words of emotion, words that express emotion. And it's indicating a certain transition of emotions. So it's like, I'm doing fine, I hear some news, I am surprised. This transition between I'm totally chill, well, now I'm surprised, or now I'm happy, is when we use the verb ficar. And I'll give you examples to make it clear. So this one is saying, Silvia's father passed. I was very sad at the news. It's a transition. I'm fine. I hear the news, I get sad. So transition of emotions, I use the verb ficar. O pai da Silvia faleceu. Fiquei muito triste com a notícia. O pai da Silvia faleceu. Fiquei muito triste com a notícia. This one I'm saying, we were surprised at Anna's new look. So again, something happened and it changed how we were feeling. Nós ficamos surpresos com o novo visual da Anna. Nós ficamos surpresos com o novo visual da Anna. I have a surprise for Camila. I think she's going to be very happy. Tenho uma surpresa para Camila. Acho que ela vai ficar muito feliz. Tenho uma surpresa para Camila. Acho que ela vai ficar muito feliz. You need to take better care of yourself or you're going to end up getting sick. By the way, I have a whole lesson on how to use this you're going to end up doing something and I'll put the link in the video description. Você precisa se cuidar melhor ou vai terminar ficando doente. Você precisa se cuidar melhor ou vai terminar ficando doente. When Jacqueline left home, it started to rain. She got totally wet. Quando Jacqueline saiu de casa, começou a chover. Ela ficou toda molhada. Quando Jacqueline saiu de casa, começou a chover. Ela ficou toda molhada. Great, so I have a lesson with 10 common emotions in Portuguese. It's going to be useful because that's usually when you use the verb ficar with emotions. And I also have a lesson that is going to show you another use of the verb ficar. We use it to indicate like permanent or relatively permanent location of things. And I have a lesson on 4 ways to ask where is in Portuguese, and the lesson is going to use the verb ficar because it's one of the ways to ask where is. So I'll put the link in the video description, or you can just find the lesson in my blog or on my YouTube channel. Street Smart Brazil offers one-on-one lessons via Skype. It's live with a webcam and you're practicing one-on-one with your own private Brazilian Portuguese tutor. You know, practice really is the key to speaking well and to using correctly all the new things you're learning. You know, there's only so much apps, videos, textbooks can do for you. To speak fluently, speak with ease, speak naturally, you need to speak. And what better way to practice than with a professional Brazilian Portuguese Street Smart Brazil tutor. So look us up, streetsmartbrazil.com. Obrigada for watching this lesson. Tchau, tchau.